All right, welcome to a new video series on YouTube on aerodynamics, and it's brought to you, of course, by the Science of Flight, a new brand here on YouTube. I'm excited to start this series with you and to kind of help you in mastering aerodynamics. In this first video, we're going to be covering the question, what is aerodynamics? So let's go ahead and get started with that. Let's start with deconstructing the word aerodynamics. It can be broken up into two parts, aero and dynamics. Aero, of course, means air. The main object under consideration in aerodynamics is actually air. Dynamics means we will be studying objects in motion as opposed to its relative, the discipline called statics, which means the study of objects in equilibrium, or that usually means at rest. Often the study of aerodynamics actually begins with some aerostatics, or the study of air in equilibrium, before moving into the actual aerodynamics. Putting it all together, aerodynamics is the study of air in motion. This will be explored further in the next slide. However, a bit of clarification of terms before we move on. Often aerodynamics is referred to as gas dynamics, or even on rare occasion as fluid dynamics. Gas dynamics is the study of gases in motion, and fluid dynamics is the study of fluids in motion. Air being a gas means aerodynamics is a subset of gas dynamics, like the diagram on the right shows. Likewise, gas being a fluid, just like liquids, means gas dynamics is a subset of fluid dynamics. Now be careful when using the terminology because they are not fully interchangeable. Aerodynamics, being the subset, can be considered fluid dynamics, though not all fluid dynamics can be considered aerodynamics. For example, hydrodynamics, or the study of water while in motion, is considered fluid dynamics because liquid is a fluid, but cannot be considered as aerodynamics because it is not the study of air under motion. So be careful when you're using these terms and make sure that you're using the right one. Now, the next video will actually talk about some of the implications that arise since aerodynamics is actually a subset of fluid dynamics. It actually inherits some properties and equations from its parent discipline, fluid dynamics, and we'll talk about that in the next video. So what do I mean when I say the motion of air? It is generally the study of air as it interacts with different objects. A quick example of flow around an object might help to clarify the meaning. Let's start with a two-dimensional uniform flow of air, as you see here on the slide. Uniform means that the flow of air is unchanging in direction, pressure, temperature, and velocity, these being some of the most important parameters that we talk about in aerodynamics. The object under study in this example will be an ellipse. This ellipse will be placed into the uniform flow of air, thereby changing the properties of the air and the flow around it. Now, after the flow reaches equilibrium, this change is then observed and/or measured. In our example, we might study the different pressures that develop around the object as felt on the surface of the object, our ellipse. This is known as the pressure distribution. And from this pressure distribution, we can determine the forces and moments that the ellipse experiences. For instance, the ellipse will feel a drag force due to the flow of the air around it, assuming this isn't a potential flow situation, but we'll talk about what that means in a future video. By varying the properties of the flow, for instance, varying the velocity, and also varying the orientation of the ellipse to the oncoming air, for instance, changing the angle at which the flow hits the object. By varying these different parameters, we can actually begin to develop an aerodynamic model of how our object behaves as it interacts with an oncoming flow of air. The ability to do this as an aerospace engineer is important, since two of the four forces of flight, fundamental forces of flight, namely lift and drag, are actually aerodynamic forces caused by the flow of air around the aircraft. The other two forces of flight being weight and thrust, but we'll talk about these in a different video. Aerodynamics isn't only concerned with the flow around an object. The motion of air can also mean how the air will behave as it flows through an object, like engines, nozzles, or even pipe flow. Aerodynamics can also mean the study of air without interacting with an object at all. An example of this would be studying smoke as it transitions from a laminar flow to a turbulent flow. And we'll talk about that in a different video as well. All right, that was the end of the first video. If you like what you saw and you want to see some more, then go ahead and show some support for this channel. You can do that by liking the video, clicking on the icon right there to subscribe to the channel, or commenting below and answering the question of the video. The question for this video is, what are some tools that could be developed that will help you better learn aerodynamics? You know, is there some apps that could be made? Is there some virtual reality models that could be built? Is there some 3D printing that can take place that will help you kind of master aerodynamics? If you have a nice idea for something like that, go ahead and throw it in the comments below. We'll love to hear from you. If not, go ahead and click on the thumbnail right there for the next video in the series. It's going to talk about aerodynamics as it's taught in college, as well as in other fields. Once again, thank you for watching the video, and if you haven't already, like, comment, subscribe. Thank you very much. See you in the next video.